This is a piece of fleece and I'm gonna make it behave like a loudspeaker, just with light. And when I say light, I mean really just light. The result is amazing, but it turned out to be not that easy to achieve. And doing this experiment, I also stumbled upon a weird effect, really weird. The whole story started when I coughed a severe cold. I don't know you, but when I feel unwell with a mild fever, I spend an entire day reading. That's how I came across an article mentioning Alexander Graham Bell and his experiments with photoacoustics. I was immediately fascinated and wanted to try replicating them. A photoacoustic phenomena is when a beam of light is projected toward an object, and this object expands and contracts, which in turn generates an acoustic wave. It requires a pulsating light that is projected to the material, and the material expands when the lights is shine on it, and contracts when the light goes off. And this expansion and contraction is in turn transferred to the surrounding medium, in which an acoustic wave is generated, and this acoustic wave can be picked up with the microphone. So this is basically the setup. Here we have the microphone. Please don't look at the hair clip. As a target, I used material. I used tape, black tape, that was attached on top of the microphone, a bigger tape, aluminum foil, and this Vero board. Of course, this expansion and contraction is really tiny, and therefore the acoustic wave generated is tiny. So it is necessary to have a very sensitive microphone and a really powerful light. The light is a projector that is powered through that box, this one, that has been modified. So there is internally a diode that chops the light mains frequency for the purpose of detecting the pulses is just enough. And here there is the recorder and the headphone to check the signal. And the effect is basically caused by, because the material is heated up and cooled down very rapidly. And therefore this causes this expansion and contraction.
The photoacoustic effect was first discovered by Alexander Graham Bell, the inventor of the telephone and of the photophone.
And it was when he was perfectioning his invention, the photophone, when he came across this phenomena while he was chopping a sunbeam using a spinning disc, perforated spinning disc, to chop, alternatively chop the beam, and the beam hit a material that generated a little bit of sound, and he discovered this phenomena in this way. So I thought that if he was able to do this with the crude technology that he had at the time, why I would not be able to reproduce this experiment today, that I have very sensitive microphones, amplifiers, and very powerful lights, LED lights. Yeah. Well, it was supposed to be easy to do, right? After all, what Bell had that I don't, but nothing worked, nothing. ha ha.
Record. Ha! Whoa! It works! It works! Ha! That's really cool.
That's a pretty cool, isn't it? So I searched more deeply on the web, and I found a document from the Acoustical Society of Korea, where they described the whole invention of Bell and the Bell's phonoacoustical research. And there I found that Bell and his assistant tested a lot of materials and discovered that thin, porous material, black materials, are more sensitive to generate sound. So what I've done was to pick a test tube. I've inserted inside a piece of black thick cloth and inserted inside the microphone so that the tube forms a closed chamber. They isolate the inside chamber with the outside atmosphere, increasing the pressure and making the sound more easily detectable. And that worked!
Ha! Whoa!
Encouraged by this, I decided to go further, and you'll be amazed by the result. I made a special amplifier to directly drive an LED array using the headphone output of an audio amplifier that in turn received a song from my computer. The sound generated by light is then picked up with a microphone, further amplified and recorded. And here we go! You are listening to Mozart's Ein kleine Nachtmusik from Light.
It's just light.
And this is the setup. Sorry for the mess. Here we have the test tube. This is the cloth. The piece of cloth that is inside of the tube, and this is the microphone, and the microphone goes here inside the recorder where we've recorded the sound, and this is the light. It's a LED light that is driven by this Darlington transistor that acts as an amplifier, and here we have the cable that goes to the output of the preamplifier that receives the music from the computer, and then this cable reaches here, and this is the power supply that gives the energy.
Nowadays, this effect is commonly exploited in photoacoustic spectroscopes and similar instruments. However, what amazed me most is how Bell and his assistant Charles Sumtainer managed to make this discovery. I tried myself making the same slotted wheel and put the mouth of the test tube attached to my ear, but honestly, I heard everything, like dogs, sirens, people hammering, but any ticking as I expected to hear. And I have the same wonder with other scientific experiments of the past. Of course, we live in a polluted environment, including sound, but maybe people in the past were more attentive observers of nature's wonders than we are now.
And doing various tests to make this thing to work, I also tested this diaphragm, which is a piezoelectric sensor, a piezoelectric transducer, but I found something really weird with this thing. The stop, I've put the disc, the piezoelectric sensor. Here we have the light. Let's turn on the light and see. Whoa. what happens. And you see, there is a interesting effect. Here we have the oscilloscope, where we can see here the pink trace indicates a photo sensor that shows the pulsating light, while the yellow trace indicates the voltage coming from the piezoelectric sensor. As you can see, there is a little bit of oscillation that is in sync with the signal, the pink trace, but there's also a DC component that increases when I put the light closer and decreases when I put the light farther away from the sensor. So this is something that is proportional to the intensity of the light, but it seems not really related with the photoacoustic phenomena. This is when I turn off the light, there's an opposite voltage from the piezoelectric sensor. This is pretty weird. So what I found is that this side of the sensor could expose maybe a small portion of the piezoelectric material that is lead zircon titanate, and that is also sensitive to light. Maybe this is a photoelectric effect. So let's try to do another thing. So I put upside down the sensor. So here we have just the brass disc that stops the light. What I do is to create a light barrier around it. Now the light can't go below this sensor. So let's try again. The same thing happens. We have the same effect as it was before. You can see from the oscilloscope. This is pretty interesting because piezoelectric sensors are not supposed to be sensitive to light, right? So after making some research, I think the only possibility here is that there is the pyroelectric effect in place. This is because the light causes some increase in temperature, but this increase in temperature is averaged by the disk, and this causes some strains in the piezoelectric material that generates a voltage. And this, I think, is the possible explanation of this phenomena. But it's pretty interesting. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if so, hit the thumb up icon and subscribe to the channel, ringing the bell icon, so you won't miss any further video from me. And that's all, folks, for today. Thanks for watching. Bye.